Team USA. Oh, I just broke my tripod. That's awesome. Yeah, Hebrew bro, you've been on my mind today, dude. I hope you're having a good day. I can't really read that comment. It just flashes quicker than my eyes can see. I'm gonna tell you though, I woke up later in the day than I wanted to because I was up watching the tubes. But I felt extra motivation today. Came down to the batting cages. I was hitting 80 and 70 miles per hour. I made a video, a static video. I'll upload it later. I'm going through physical therapy situations right now, so it was actually a fun way to check up on my hand-eye coordinations. Spike Radio. I just can't get enough. Yeah, good vibes. Anybody, any of the thousands of people that might tune in, 1 PS Center channel is a great place to be. The live streams. Oh, I should wrench you up. I can't do that from my phone, bro. I suck at YouTube streaming. But if there's any mod in my channel, please post 1 PS Sinners page, Hebrews page. Oh, don't do it. This batting cage is called Malibu Castle. I realize I'm screaming and these batters are looking at me like, what are you screaming at? But I walked up. It's pretty popular out here in LA. I'm like 10 minutes away from Calabasas, and when I was walking up to get my base, my bat, what's up, highway? I think I saw Courtney Kardashian. One of the Kardashians. Courtney or Khloe? Khloe. The mom. I'm pretty sure I saw her walking up with her Sancho. That was weird. I wonder if you guys can hear the sound of the ball in the bat. It's like calming sounds. It's like therapy to me. Yeah, that guy's smacking. The batting cage closest to me is softball. I've never done a softball batting cage. distance hammering them. The cages far off are baseball. The farthest one I think is 90 miles per hour. Oh no, the farthest one is a Yum, what's up, Yum? The farthest one is slow pitch softball. The ones in the middle are 80 or 90. That's where I was batting. I didn't hit the ball like I used to, but I hit the ball pretty well. For anyone who knows what I've been through this last month, I'm actually very proud of myself for smacking the shit out of the ball today. My swing was rusty though. Just my stance was pretty good. My footing was all right, but my swing was a little rusty. I was a little stiff. Y'all just too good to be true. Thank you for tuning in to Spike Radio on this lovely Tuesday afternoon. 88 degrees in North Hollywood. Running. 102 degrees in Las Vegas. Actually, 400 feet spike. In all my years, I never cleared a fence. But I was a power hitter once upon a time. Lots of triples. My first year in high school, I had so many triples. Which is great, but especially when you're a kid, you're just like, why can't I hit those homers? Highway Star knows his baseball. Love it. I ruined my baseball career by playing football. And so will most kids. For all you children out there listening, play baseball. Don't go for football. You will hurt yourself. Went live because I didn't see anyone live. Just wanted to give y'all a place to chill and chat. You play center field? Bro, you got wheels. However, I do think King Troll just went live as I went live. If that is the case, y'all might want to, anyone out there might want to check out King Troll. Center field. I was a catcher. I was a catcher, but they always say that's the captain of the field, but I based a lot of what I was doing on the field by watching the center fielder. Diana Saria Moore is in the house. I loved catching. I was such a loud, talkative catcher. Deanna, I was just telling the hundreds of people in the chat that I decided to work on some physical therapy, hand-eye coordination, by hitting some baseballs today. And I did pretty well. Did all right.
Push what technology can.
You know, all the holy stations are just commercials these days. I need to stop abusing the copyright, because all my live streams just get blocked. I don't even have a chance to edit them, which sucks because I want to play music. I wonder if I do it like in 10 second intervals. I mean, I could just sing. If I sing, will it be copyrighted? In sleep she came to me, all strange duet. My power over you grows stronger yet. And though you turn from me, to glance behind, the phantom of the opera is here inside your mind. Hey, a baseball in Sydney. Oh, I'm so tired just from 100 pitches. My body isn't used to that. My best friend was catcher. We had to play healing purposely overthrow the short. Yes! I don't know if I think that comment was the highway, you're still here. Yes, that was the best trick play. Or also when you pretend you're throwing it to the pitcher, but you overthrow the pitcher. Is that what you were talking about? Oh man, those were the days. Highway Star, if I ever bump into you, I'm gonna have to bring some gloves so we can play some catch. I used to always do that. I used to always carry two baseball mitts in the back and a ball. And the little things, those little types of things I need to remember to do. You just never know when someone wants to play catch. Nobody ever wants to play catch. That's why I have to impose it on them. Yeah, just a little bucket in the back seat or in the trunk, or if you have in the truck, whatever. And always, I would always carry a tennis ball and a baseball, because a lot of people don't want to play with a hard ball. So I used to, I'm going to bore people with baseball talk except Highway Star. So I used to have one of my things, one of my powers was my arm. And I used to, from the ready position, from squatting position, I used to throw people out at second base just when they're leading off. In my squatting position, basically. And how I learned that, how I learned to do that, well, when I used, even when I coach kids, I would teach them this, but you stand on second base and you try to throw strikes from second base as a catcher, just in practice. When you start getting those throws in well, then reverse it as catcher, you'd be able to throw strikes to the second baseman to get those leadoff runners. I loved baseball. I mean, I loved three or four sports growing up as a kid. But I loved baseball. And in high school, I decided to play baseball and football. That was a mistake. Football ruined my left hand. My hand got caught in a helmet, in another guy's helmet. Tore up my hand, which was my catching hand. I used to catch for a guy named Javier de la Hoya. He was older than I was, but he went on to play for the Dodgers. Doxing myself. But yeah, with a messed up left hand, I could no longer hit the ball as well because my grip, I couldn't tighten my grip on the bat. Catching, I could still catch, but it was painful on every pitch. This guy was throwing at least 88, 90 miles per hour. For a 15-year-old, that was hard. And I also ended up messing my knee up in football, so catching was a struggle. I'm just putting it out there for all the kids. For all those kids that may be watching the Spike Stream, if you can play both, play one, play baseball. I'm really bummed out. I busted my tripod when I set this up just now. So I can't even drive without my phone falling over. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. I feel fine. Thank you for tuning in to Spike Radio. Oh, Jack Harlow, the new White Men Can't Jump movie is horrible. Don't waste your time.
Ford is already on board. Thank you.
What you gonna do with your life? That's all they really want.
You see that guy walking in there right now? He's looking at me. He remembers me from back in the days when I used to come over here. I have another video of me hitting the ball. I might have removed it after all the doxing threats on YouTube. It's still on my Instagram, but my Facebook, but that guy cranked up the cages for me last time I was here. His cages, his machines don't really go to 100, but he can manipulate it where he was, they were doing maintenance on it, and he told me I can hit, and he said it was over 90, close to 100. And that video, before my hospital vacation, that video, I was smacking the ball. Oh man, and even in that video, the sound of the bat and the ball, it's like foreplay. Sorry, earmuffs out there, hitting the ball like that is orgasmic. Earmuffs. In my entire life, I don't know if I ever hit the ball like I did that day. I'm too old to be playing around like that. But it was refreshing. I mean, my swing's still not what it was when I was my young kiddo days. Just the extension you get in your shoulders is different. I need to do more yoga, more Tai Chi. / I don't do any yoga or Tai Chi. See that guy walking around just checking out everything? That's like the dream job. I love the owner, this guy here. I think he's the owner. That'd be so awesome just to run a batting cage on summer. I looked into it once. You can do a mobile one, like on a truck. Video off live of just going through the arcade and everything. I can't wait to upload it. Some of those heads out there will appreciate it, like Jeremy Iring, video game master.
Rockin' man, 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 rockin' man
Let's take you on a little tour. Harley. Harley Fodded. Did you hear that? Harley Fodded.
Microphone check.
I used to run summer camps and we'd bring the kids here. And I'd always walk way over here to light up a cigarette while the kids were in there miniature golfing. I was always running off. I just need 7 minutes. I need to get a quick smoke in. Yeah, just so you, I know I'm doxing my location, but most of the movies that, this is just a fringe benefit of LA, it's not a big deal, but most of the movies you guys see when they film like a miniature golf or TV shows, when they film miniature golf, it's actually here, to be honest. Unless it's golf and stuff like Karate Kid and Cobra Kai. But Valley Heart, part of the irony of me being a Valley boy, I was actually born on the Valley Heart Drive, way down there though. But yeah, this is a Castle Park, a very respected, celebrated miniature golf place with batting cages. The batting cages when I was a kid, though, was actually Malibu Grand Prix, a little, you know, those little Grand Prix cars you can drive. Right off the 101 freeway. Anybody who wants to pull up, come on and pull up. Those palm trees look fake. That's so funny. When I played outfield in my very young years of baseball and what they call pitch T-ball, I was so aloof. I'd sit in right field. There's photos of me where I'd just be standing in right field with the glove over my face like this. Hey, look, Anna, got a little manicure there, soft manicure. Where I just have the hand, the glove over my face, like, I'm bored. But my best memory of playing outfield was the Dragonflies. I actually want a tattoo of a dragonfly on my back just because of those memories of the Dragonflies and playing right field. wearing my new hoodie. Yeah, so right when I pulled up, I think I saw, is it Kourtney or Khloe Kardashian, the older one? I think I saw her walking up with her boy. Her Sancho. And he came over to the batting cages, looked like he wanted to play, but he didn't. Dang, I'm having flashbacks. Another hiding spot to go smoke when I would run to the summer camps was way over there. I have switched over to vaping. I don't want to promote tobacco use, but I am the one thing. I can cut carbs, I can cut sugars, I'm not addicted to any kind of alcohol or drugs, thank God. But the one thing that's hard to kick is tobacco. But I started vaping this week. I've cut down my cigarettes in half, so that's a start. I like to be transparent, you know, because it's cliche, but maybe we learn from other people's mishaps or mistakes. Best times. Hey, you know what? Fast Times at Ridgemont High was filmed right here, actually, one block up.
All right. So get some French fries.
Let's go get some French fries. What a. That's kind of adorable. It's like, go to the batting cages, go to the arcade, and let's get French fries. Man, this guy's out in his whole entire uniform. It's good stuff. Hey, Deanna or somebody, I know he said don't do it, but if you could post a link to Hebrew's channel, 1SP Center, 1PS Center, because those are some good vibes. So I demand to post it. Also, I need to, oh, you did? Thank you. I don't know how to do any, like, functions while I'm on stream or on live stream. Just the sound of the batting machine, I love it. I'm such a weirdo. I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. What about the green? Oh, are you rebutting me saying I wasn't addicted to something? I very much am a master at hitting the bingus, fat bong loads, but I've never been addicted to, they always say it's non-addictive. I've never been addicted to green. In fact, I spent $500 on green products right before my birthday a month ago. But if you didn't know, on my birthday, I actually had a mishap. I ended up in the hospital. And even though the nurse said, you know, the green is medicinal. It can help me with what I'm going through right now. I haven't smoked in a month. I have all this amazing flower sitting in my home. I'm not even smoking. I don't want to risk anything right now. So emotional damage. But I definitely support the green, 100%. There's so many good aspects of it. As far as inspirational, motivational, medicinal. Vic Ferrari, yes. If Vic's here, shout out Vic. My battery is at 10%, and I don't want to get stuck where it gets stuck in a live stream, so I'm going to end it. Oh, yes, Highway Star, I love it. I love it. Yeah, I'm not giving up. I mean, I did eat a gummy a week ago. And really, the doctors and nurses, you know, because you have to tell them what you do, and I don't really do anything but smoke some good grass. And they definitely did not. The only thing they said that smoking it, obviously, the inhalation and the carcinogens of smoking. One of my doctors said, "Well, you're basically smoking a tree, so you have to remember that part." So yeah, the inhalation of smoke is not good for me or anyone. But they actually, not one of my medical professionals told me not to smoke. But what happened the other day on my live stream is it went down to like 4%, and then I ended up, my stream got like stuck. So I'm gonna end this now, guys. I appreciate you. If King Troll is live, please go kick out or check out King Troll. He runs a fun channel. Other than that, shout out to all y'all. One love, peace. Remember to tell someone you love them today. Give a hug to someone who's least expecting it from you. All right. And also talk shit if you have to. Let motherfuckers know. Spike out of here. Peace out. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Deanna. I don't know how to do this. Are you sure you want to stop streaming? Want is not the right word. Are you sure you need to stop streaming? Yes. Okay.